In a previous video, we looked at the principle behind connecting certain types of LED fittings in series. Now we're at the stage where we need to connect up our LED lights from Collingwood, as you can see here, and we really don't want to destroy them by connecting them up incorrectly. We also need to make sure that we're using an LED driver that can be used in an outdoor environment and therefore has the right IP rating. Now, in a previous video, we looked at the importance of connecting this type of fitting to a constant current driver in series with each other. So if you haven't seen that, then please go and have a look at it, as it explains the principles behind this video. In that video, it was really easy to connect the fittings in series, as all the conductors could be brought to the same position, and you could clearly see that the fittings were connected in series with each other. But often when you come to do real-world installations, things are sometimes a little bit trickier. The principles stay the same, but it can be harder to visualise what's going on with the connections. So we're going to do a real installation using a constant current driver and these series connected fittings. So we've got four of these spike lights that I'm going to install into this strip of gravel here, and then I'm going to angle the heads so that they sort of illuminate the front area of the lawn. Now, it's worth noting here that this is not the main source of illumination for the lawn. The idea is that the light from these will just kind of graze across the lawn and add some texture and detail to the grass and the lighting scheme. Now, for the purposes of this video, I'm just going to lay the cables out on the surface here so that we can clearly see where they go and how the fittings connect to each other. Realistically, I'd probably drill holes for the cables through the top here and then run them inside this rebated slot here to keep them out of view. So let's apply some of the basic principles from the previous video. We've got here LEDs that can run on either a constant current of 350 milliamps or 700 milliamps, but I want to use 350 milliamps for the lower light level. Using this current, each one will dissipate 1 watt of power, so that's 4 watts of power in total. So I'm going to need a driver that will alter its voltage to always deliver 350 milliamps of current. I've got some different drivers here from Collingwood that I could use. So this one is not going to work, because if you look on here, you can see that this is going to try and deliver 700 milliamps of current, which is not the value I want. So that one's out. Both of these ones will deliver 350 milliamps, so that's great. But this one is designed to deliver 1 to 9 watts of power, and this one 1 to 5 watts. So either would be fine, and I'm happy to fit the smaller driver. Now, I'm sure that by now you're all shouting at the screen that this driver is actually not the right choice, because obviously this driver is designed to be used indoors. It wouldn't last long out here with the various external influences it would be subjected to. And that's where these excellent drivers from Collingwood come in. They're rated at IP65 and will therefore fit perfectly into this installation. The connections in and out of the drivers are hardwired, which means that you're not going to be able to bodge up the connections and compromise the IP rating by the lid not going on correctly. So we've got two examples here of the IP rated driver. This one has a constant current of 700 milliamps, which is obviously more than we want to use in this installation and will produce too bright a light output. But this one has a constant current of 350 milliamps. So this is the one to go with. And if we just check the power rating on here, you can see that that can deliver up to 9 watts of power. So that more than meets our needs. So let's have a look at the physical installation here. I'm going to place the driver under the decking that's going to live under there out of sight. But for the sake of this video and for the sake of clarity, I'm just going to keep it out here initially and plonk it down on there. Now, obviously, we're going to be making outdoor connections, so we'll have a look at these IP68 rated connectors in a moment. But for the time being, let's just consider the connections themselves. Now, it's possible, using one of these connections here, to connect together up to 3 LED fittings to the driver. Now, if we're just going to connect one, it's really obvious how that's going to work. We're just going to connect the positive from the driver, which is this cable here. It's just going to go to the positive of the light fitting, and the negatives will also go together nice and simply, so that's not a problem. Now, if you're going to connect 2 fittings together, that's where it starts to get a little bit different. You need to connect the negative back from fitting number 1 to the positive of fitting number 2. Now, I must admit at this point, I find it super helpful just to label up the fittings with numbers so that I don't lose track of which one's which. So let's just connect these together to demonstrate. So we'll put the positive and the negative from the driver into these 2 terminals here. So we'll screw those down and make sure that they've been nipped up nicely. And then we're going to pick up the positive connection from the driver with the positive connection from fitting number 1. So we're going to connect that into there like that. Now, if this was just 1 fitting by itself, then obviously we'd connect the 2 negatives together like so, assemble the connector, no problem. But what we're going to do here is we're going to move that across into this connection here instead. So we'll just get that put inside this terminal, and then we'll see what happens with our other connection. So if you cast your mind back to the other video that we made, you'll remember that for the next point, we need to pick up the positive for fitting number two, needs to come from the negative of fitting number one in order for the current to be able to flow through this in the correct direction. So we'll put that in there like that. And then we'll put the negative from fitting number two. So there's fitting number two. The negative goes into this end terminal like so. Screw that up nice and tight. And then what we need to do is put a little link connection between the end of the circuit, which is fitting number two, the negative, then needs to go to the negative back to the driver in this cable here. So we'll just put this little link that I've made up in here like so. We pick up the negative from fitting number two, and then that goes off back to the driver, and you can see there that the circuit will be complete. So we'll just get that put in there. Screw that down nice and tight. And that is the connection made. So you can see the current's going to flow down the positive to fitting number one through the lamp, back down the negative into the positive of fitting number two through the lamp, and then back down the negative to this point here where it goes back to the negative of the driver. Now let's have a look at what happens if we've got three fittings connected in series. So we'll bring our third fitting in here now. So you can see I've labeled this up again as fitting number three, just to help me keep track of which fitting is which. And then it's very simply just a matter of removing this little link here. And we just follow the same logic that we followed at every step in this procedure, which is that the positive from the new fitting picks up the negative from the previous one. So here we've got the positive of fitting number three. That's going to pick up the negative from fitting number two. So we'll connect that in there like that. Screw that down nice and tight. And then you can see that what happens is that the negative from fitting number three goes onto the negative of the driver. So you can see there, that's a pretty good rule of thumb, just as a guide to help you make sure that you're getting these connections in the right places, that actually the colours from the first connection to the driver and the last connection to the driver should be the same. So in other words, this positive connection should go to a positive connection on the fitting, and this negative connection on the driver should go to a negative connection on the fitting also. Now, we've seen a principle to follow when it comes to the connections, and actually they just stay the same when we move to four fittings. But the difference now is that we need an additional connector, as there wouldn't have been enough room in the first one. And in reality, if you've got your fittings laid out in a long line like we have here, then you'd need an additional one anyway. Now, Collingwood have done me a massive favour by having a generous amount of cable on each fitting, so that I only need to have two connector positions for four fittings. Now, we just follow the same direction as before. The positive comes from the driver. So you can see here, here's the driver, and here's our positive connection. And that positive connection is going to go to the positive of fitting number one. So I'm just going to get these put into the connectors to start with, so we've got those positioned. So we'll get those connected up, and then we'll take it from there. So there we go, that's our positive and negative connection from the driver coming in there. So then we'll bring into play our cable number one. So here comes cable number one, and we're going to connect onto that the positive to the positive from the driver. So that just goes in there like that. And then, very similar to the setup we had before, we're going to put the negative of fitting number one into that connector there. So there you can see we've got that setup like that. And then we pick up from the negative of fitting number one, we take the positive of fitting number two. So that's going to go into there like so. So we're just going to pick that up there. So we'll put the positive into that terminal and screw that down. And then we'll put the negative into that terminal. And as you can see, this is looking remarkably familiar to what we had before. So now we've got fittings numbers one and two connected. Now we need to take the electrical connections on to position number three and four for those light fittings there. So hopefully we know where this is going now. I need to pick up the negative connection from fitting number two, and I need to take it to the positive connection of fitting number three. But instead of this being connected over here, it's going to be connected over here. So what I need to do is to pick up that negative connection and bring it over here. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to pick up the negative connection from light number 2, and I'm going to connect it to the positive of the third fitting. Now, don't be tempted at this stage to use the black in this connecting cable. Stick with the red, and it'll make far more sense in a moment if we stick to the pattern we've already used. So I've got the positive, effectively, of fitting number 3, and I'm going to take that down to here and put that into this terminal here. So that's just going to go in there like so. Just loosen that off a little bit and get that in there. So there we go. I'm just going to leave that other black cable from here disconnected for now, because we'll see the significance of that in a minute. Okay, so that now becomes the positive connection from fitting number 3. So I'm going to put that in there like that. So that is the positive connection to fitting number 3 now. I'm just slacking that terminal off just a little bit and get that in there like so. And then we're back to a similar position where we were before, where now we need to think about what we're going to do with this one. So from this position here, we're going to take the negative connection from fitting number 3. And hopefully by this stage, we know what we're going to be doing here. We're going to connect that into the positive connection of fitting number 4. So that is going to go into there like so. There's the positive connection from fitting number 4. So again, that probably just needs a little bit of a loosen there to get that in. There we go. And we'll tighten that up. And we'll put the negative from light number 4 into that terminal there. And then very similar to what we did when we had just 2 fittings connected previously, we're now going to put a little link from the negative of light number 4. That's going to go from there over to there and in there like that, and tighten that up. And then look at that, we've got a negative connection left over, and that's going to go onto there like that. So we'll connect that in there and just loosen it off just a little bit, make life as easy as we can. So we'll push that into there like that, and that gives us our return connection now. So what that then does is that becomes the negative connection effectively from light fitting number 4, and that's going to go back down the black conductor. Remember I said earlier it makes sense later. We then connect that returning negative conductor, goes onto the return leg, the return negative if you like, of the driver. And there it is, that's our connections completed. Now obviously what we've done here is I've kept this as a very short piece of cable so you can see where the connections are, and actually I could leave it like this because the cables are long enough, but in reality you can make this interconnecting cable longer so that you've got a greater distance between the two different positions for the connector blocks. So let's just track where the current's going to go. It's going to come from the driver down the positive cable through the positive connection of fitting number 1, pass through the lamp and come back down the negative again, go down the positive of light fitting number 2, come back down the negative again, and then it's going to track down this cable onto the positive of fitting number 3, go down the positive number 3, go through the LED fitting, back on the negative, through the positive of LED fitting number 4, and then come back down the negative, through the link there, and then back to here and back to the driver down the negative there, thus completing the circuit and putting all the lamps connected in series. Now if you ever have more than 4 connections to make, you can just continue with the same principle. If you want to add a 5th light, you can remove this link and simply wire it in here, and if you're going up to 6, then this first connection after the driver would get repeated in this position, and then this connection would get bumped to the final connection position at a fresh connector. Couldn't be simpler. Now let's have a closer look at one of these neat little connector blocks here. So having made the connections, it's just a matter of enclosing them into these excellent IP68 connector blocks. So the first thing that you need to do is just to crack off these little spacers that sit on the side here. So we'll just remove those while we're
here. I'm going to do all four of those, and these are just here to prevent the gel from kind of bonding in the two halves while the product is in transit. So they're gone, and now that'll be able to clamp together all the way without any issues there. So then it's a matter of just removing these little nibs here, and these come out really easily, and just remove the little barriers that correspond to the cable positions that you're putting in. So I'm going to take both out of this side and then one there, so we'll get rid of those. So we'll just remove those off camera now, and as you can see, those have been removed so that these will match up with each other when we put these together. So we've got two from that end and one from that end, so that'll fit in really nicely and seal this up. Then we need to pop in these little reducing adapters here, because we're using quite small cables here, so we'll snap those off and just put them in the relative position there. It's really nice and easy because they're kind of molded, they've got these little slots in them that map into those positions there like that. So we'll just put in three of those on each. Okay, so with those little barriers snapped off and with the reducing adapters in place, it's just a matter of pressing these connectors into the gel that's gonna squish around that and hold that in. Just make sure that the outer sheath goes all the way into the fitting there, and then it's just a matter of popping that on the top and squeezing it together. And then the little nibs on either side, there's little plastic catches, you can see are just squeezing that together. That's got that in place, and then it's just a matter of popping in these screws. So you can see there's a recess part here to pop the screw into, and then just a matter of doing it up. So we'll crank that one into there, and then because they've made the two halves of this absolutely identical, what then happens is that you have to flip it over to pop the other one in. So we'll flip it over and pop that one in, and that is that now all nice and sealed up. I think that is a really excellent bit of kit. I really like that IP68. I'm confident that that's completely sealed up. You can see where the gel's kind of squeezed out a little bit there, meaning that there's absolutely no fear of any moisture getting inside there now. I think that's absolutely fantastic. So there we go. It's now time for my absolutely favorite part of any electrical job. It's time to power up the lights and see what it looks like. So we'll wait till it gets dark and then we'll turn it all on. So there we go. Using the correct equipment from Collingwood and following the correct installation methods, you'll have an installation that brings light to the garden for years to come. Thank you very much for watching.